Hey there, my name is Andre. Today I'm going to be milling up a walnut log that we got from a tree that was dead at the base. So figured I'd show you guys the process for that. So this is the log itself. It's about 26 feet long. And let me get my tape measure and I can take some dimensions on it as far as the diameter. Down here at the base, 27 inches. And then up here farther along in the tree here, to get an idea. Probably 24 inches, about 2 feet. There's some crotch figure down in there. There's three big parts to it there. And then there's also farther up where some additional logs that came out of it. This one here, about 17 inches. Show you what I'm talking about, where the tree was kind of dying there at the base. The bark was peeling off and you can see it starting to rot down in there. So figured instead of having it just fall wherever it wants to, whenever it wants to, we'd go ahead and take it down. That way we can deal with it and hopefully get some nice walnut wood out of it. I generally go for about 9-foot logs. We've had some other trees that have fallen on the property and I've done it that way. Much heavier if they're longer, so I try to keep it towards that length. The wet wood can be pretty heavy, so. Alright. So I think the first thing we're gonna do is try to get a better cut on the end here. When the tree fell, it split the stump, and I think part of that, the way it ripped the grain there, I'm a little worried that maybe it might be damaged further down in there. You know, maybe not very far, but so I'm just gonna lop off a few inches here and try to get a clean cut on it. I got a 36 inch bar, so I should be able to do it just on one swipe, so we'll do that. All right, so we got 2 9-foot logs now, and I'm out of breath because I'm out of shape. And before I forget here, I'm gonna go ahead and put some paint on the ends, just to give you guys a picture of what it looks like. The rings on this tree aren't very close together. It's sitting right next to a creek, so it's had a pretty easy life. Imagine that made it grow pretty fast. I did a quick count. It's about 65 years old or so. So it's not super old for being in the woods like it is, but it's got some age to it. Easier to do this before you cut the log. When you stack it up and you got all your stickers in there and it's up on wherever you have it, and you got to paint each individual slab. So I try to do this before I stack it, if I remember to. There it is painted. This paint color is from Home Depot, Sonic Silver, for anyone who's interested. Actually got it for a shed I built, and we didn't like the color so much. So I just saved it in case we needed it for anything else. Alright. Go first cut. It was not so pretty when you first cut it, but as it oxidizes, as it dries out a little on the surface there, it turns to a richer brown. Pretty cool.
A lot darker down toward the base. It's beautiful stuff. So that's the end result. It's all stacked up. Starting to dry. It'll sit here for, I don't know, 8 months or so, and then I'll take it inside. I might trim the bark off before I put it down in the basement.
So yeah, I just wanted to say, hope everyone enjoyed the video. I had a ton of fun making it. If you like the content, if you want to see more something like this, just leave a like and let me know, and we'll see what else we can do. But for now, everyone have a great day.